Hey, this is Marcus, aka Cradle Cat, and today we're going to take a look at how to set up Kontakt Studio Drummer for multi-outputs so that you can do your mixing of kicks, snares, hi-hats, all those individual sounds from Kontakt as tracks in Logic, where you would normally mix things, instead of just getting all of that Kontakt Drummer output as one track in Logic. Here's a song where I already have it set up, so we'll look at the finished product and then show how we got it. Great. So in this section, and we're just looking at the drums, we can see I'm only using a couple pieces from Kontakt Studio Drummer here, but I have the kick, hi-hat, some of the overhead stereo, room stereo outputs, and I could have had any other number of outputs I wanted as well from Kontakt. And what that looks like when it's finished is I have the individual tracks here in Logic, which I can mix like I normally would with plugins and EQs and everything on my actual Logic track while I'm still using the full power of Studio Drummer here. And you can see the main thing that we'll be setting up here today is all of these extra outputs and then how do we route those outputs from here into Logic. So let's dive in. We'll start from scratch. So the first step is setting up your Kontakt track. And when you do this, you'll want to make sure that you have your Kontakt instrument selected correctly as multi-output, 8x stereo, 8x mono. So we're going to go ahead and choose that option and click Create. And I'll label this Tutorial Kontakt. Great. So now, instead of just one stereo output, this Kontakt track is set up to be capable of all those different outputs, stereo and mono, that we just selected. For the next step, I'm actually going to bring up my mixer window. And because we set it up that way, we have this little plus button here where we can add more tracks. So I'm going to go ahead and click this plus button to fill out these tracks. And what we're seeing is it's adding a stereo output. And once I add a couple more, we'll get into those mono outputs as well. Great. Go ahead and add those through 24 there. We'll go ahead and add all of those. So now we've gone ahead and added all of those through 24. And that's just going to make it easier to see these. We'll relabel these in a second. Once we have our individual tracks set up in Logic, let's go ahead and bring up our Studio Drummer in Kontakt. Once that's loaded, we'll bring up the mixer view and settings. And we'll be messing with the routing here for our channel output, as well as the output configuration down here with preset and batch configuration. The first thing we can do is go ahead and click this plus button next to outputs. And we're going to first add our stereo outputs that we want. So we'll have eight of these, let's say, and we'll do two channels since it's a stereo track. And we'll start that on stereo one, which is the first channel that we can output to. Ascending output assignment, we'll want that checked and delete existing channels before creating new ones. Go ahead and click OK. And now we have those eight stereo outputs that we can next route into the eight stereo tracks that we just created in Logic. Before we do that, let's also go ahead and add our mono tracks outputs as well. So go ahead and say eight. We just have one channel for each of these as monos. And we'll go ahead and go to the correct output here, which is just going to be the 17th channel. Just happens to be that one because There are 8 stereo channels, so they have 2 each, and that's 16. So the next one is 17. Anyway, we do not need to check this delete existing one because we don't want to delete the stereo ones we just created. And we'll go ahead and click OK. Now you can see it started on 17 here for our mono output options down at the bottom. Something that's going to be helpful as a next step here is labeling these. It's just going to make the next few steps easier. You can use the default names here, but I'm going to go ahead and label these and you can copy them as well. Great. So now we have all of those labeled and they are now labeled and ready to be routed from our output section. You can see this has not yet been updated. So to make your life easier, go ahead and click that exclamation point at the top. And now you'll see all of our nicely labeled outputs here. So you don't have to remember which one's which. We'll go ahead and go through each one. So we want the kick to route to the kick. We want our snare to route to the snare. And so on. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, we've got all of those set up now. It's also worth noting if you did want to treat each of those toms as an individual track, you could have used some more of your output channels here to route those individually instead of just routing them all to one stereo track like I did. Now that we have this set up, whenever we actually start to play our sounds here, you can see it's showing up in the mixer. And instead of just in that main output, which is where the only sound would be showing beforehand, you see it showing up in each of these individual outputs where it's being routed. So we have some of that overhead and room sound coming through on both those hits, as well as from the snare. Now what this looks like in Logic is, if I go ahead and exit my, can't exit it yet because we only have them as these tracks here. So I can already start to mix these and everything. However, if I want to see them in my timeline view, which I do, go ahead and on each of those tracks, go to create track. This is also a good spot to begin to label all of these as well. So we have our kick. And it can be helpful also to just pull up Kontakt again so we can see exactly what those were if we don't have those memorized. So we have our kick, snare. Oh, those are in the monos, so I actually did that wrong. So we want to find our first mono one, and that is actually going to be the kick. This is going to be the snare. You can also see that the labels here will line up with your output tracks that we just set up. So we can see that snare, or the kick is output 17, snare is 18. We see that that matches up with what we've just set up here. So let's go ahead and label all of those. Same thing for stereo. It is not the kick. This is going to be our 3/4 outputs. That's going to be our toms. Overhead stereo, room stereo, and that's all we need for now. Cool. Go ahead and exit that and continue creating tracks for each of those. You can also just select all of these that we want tracks for. So I'm just going to hold Command and click all of those tracks individually. Right click, create track. So now we have all of these tracks here As you can see in the one that I actually completed, I included them on a bus for my overall drum mixing. But here we have all of our tracks coming through as individual Logic tracks. So now we can mix to our heart's desire all of these drum sounds that we're getting from Kontakt. You'll also notice as you're playing that if you're clicked onto one of those other tracks, it's not going to, when you play something, it's not going to like register that. You have to click on that main track because that's where it's actually getting the MIDI inputs. If you're using a keyboard or drum pads to play it, this is the channel that's looking for those. These are just the output channels that we set up. So I'm clicking the kick now, nothing's come through. Once I click over there, we can hear that loud and clear. Great. So now, like I mentioned, the main point of this is to be able to mix these just like we would all of our other tracks. I can go ahead and add EQ on the kick. I can add compression on each of these individually. I can control the reverb in more detail and fit it to any other room style reverbs that I might be using on other tracks in the song and get a whole more cohesive sound out of it by being able to control it the same way that I'm controlling everything else in the song. Great. So again, how we set this up, just a quick review. We inserted our new track with Kontakt, making sure that it was set up as that multi-output, 8 stereo and 8 mono. Once we did that, we went ahead and clicked our little plus button to add all the other tracks. We then went into Kontakt, brought up Studio Drummer, set up our outputs by adding 8 stereo outputs and then 8 mono outputs, labeling them, and then going through our mixer board here and changing the outputs to match. Once that was done, I went ahead and created tracks on my timeline view for each of the tracks outputs that we'd set up here. And then I could start mixing. Thanks so much for watching. Just kind of testing out, doing some more tutorial type videos on the ins and outs of Logic and just how I go about making songs. So if you guys like this, go ahead and subscribe, add some comments in the comments section, and just let me know if I should keep doing these or if there's anything else you'd want to see. Cool. Again, this is Marcus, Cradle Cat, and hope to see you next time. Take another drink. Here's the hoping that the ceiling